Recorded Books Incorporated presents an unabridged recording of The Cat Who Sang for the Bird. William Jackson Braun. Narrated by George Goodell. This work is copyrighted 1998 by Lillian Jackson Braun. This recording is copyrighted 1998 by Recorded Books Incorporated. Spring has come early to Moose County. The flowers are blooming, the birds are singing. Newspaper columnist and millionaire philanthropist Jim Sutherland, along with his two cats, are comfortable in the newly remodeled apple barn they call home. But all is not well 400 miles north of everywhere. And now, the cat who sang for the birds. Chapter 1.
Strangers were beginning to appear in the campgrounds and on the streets of downtown. One afternoon in late May, a brown van pulled into a parking lot alongside a small green sedan, and a man wearing a black jersey slipped out of the driver's seat. He glanced furtively to the left and right, and leaving the motor running, he opened the tailgate. Then he unlocked the trunk of the sedan and quickly transferred something from his vehicle to the other, at which he lost no time in driving away. An out-of-towner witnessing the surreptitious maneuver might have described him as a Caucasian male, middle-aged, about 6'2", with slightly graying hair and an enormous pepper and salt mustache. On the other hand, any resident of Pickaxe, population 3,000, would have recognized him. He was James McIntosh Quillen, columnist for the Moose County Sun, and, by a fluke of fate, the richest man in northeast central United States. He had reason to be furtive about the parking lot caper. In Pickaxe, everyone knew everyone's business and discussed it freely on the phone, on street corners, and in the coffee shops. Individuals would say, "It's nice that Polly Duncan got herself such a rich boyfriend. She's been a widow for a heck of a long time. That green sedan she drives, he gave it to her for a birthday present. Wonder what she gave him. He does her grocery shopping at Toodle's Market while she's at work and puts the stuff in her car. Makes you wonder why they don't get married. Then she could quit her job at the library." The sidewalk gossips and widows. They knew that Quillen had been an important crime reporter down below, as they called the middle south of the 49th parallel. They knew that something sinister had wrecked his career. They would say, "Then he come up here, by golly, and sell her pluck into all their nails. Up that luck." He went to the newspaper office to hand in copy for his column, straight from the quill pen. Then he stopped at the used bookstore and browsed for a while, buying a 1939 copy of the Thanks Grant book, The Daily Book. To the market, he principal's voice on the public address system ordered all students to return to the building at once and report to the auditorium. Roger looked up.
Hey, I like that black shirt, Quill. Where'd you get it?
Never mind the shirt. What goes on here?
You don't know?
The reporter glanced around before saying in a confidential tone, mock accident.